The dura mater is the outermost layer of the meninges. It's, like I said before, it's the tough mother, and it's incredibly sturdy. If you grab a hold of the dura mater, if you ever have the opportunity, you can pull on it in almost any direction and it will not tear. In this particular imagery, we have an overview of the entire dura here, covering the entire surface of the brain. And it has some specializations. There are areas where the dura comes up towards the surface and then it folds together on the midline. And that is this structure here, which is the fox cerebri. And the fox cerebri separates your two cerebral hemispheres. It lies within the superior sagittal sulcus that we talked about when we were talking about the gross anatomy of the brain. So the fox cerebri separates the two hemispheres. There's a teeny tiny little fox cerebelli that goes in between the cerebellar hemispheres, but that's really hard to see. And then there's what's called the tentorium cerebelli, and that's this area here, where if you can imagine this coming out at the screen at you, perpendicular to the fox. And tentorium cerebelli means tent over the cerebellum. And that is a tent that lies between the occipital lobe and the cerebellum below it. Other specializations that lie within the dura are the dural sinuses or the venous sinuses. And these are areas where venous blood is collecting on its way back to the heart. And we have two that you can see in this section. There's the superior sagittal sinus that runs up here in the fox, and there's the inferior sagittal sinus that runs along here in the inferior aspect of the fox cerebri. There's a straight sinus that runs here where the fox and the tentorium come together. And then just on this outer edge of the tentorium cerebelli is what we call the transverse sinus, because it's going transversely around the back. Okay. Here are some images of the base of the skull with the top of the skull and the brain removed so that you can see these meningeal layers in situ. So on this image up here, we have the fox cerebri at the top with our superior sagittal sinus opened up, and that is dark venous blood up in here. So here is, again, that superior sagittal sinus. We have the fox cerebri up here, and then we have the tentorium here. You can clearly see the straight sinus right in here. That's at the intersection of the fox and the tentorium. Looking straight down on the brain, we have the tentorium cerebelli in this area. And what you can see here again then is that straight sinus. And the C is referring to what we call the confluence of the sinuses. It's where the transverse and the straight come together with the two from with the superior sagittal and inferior sagittal. So these are areas where blood is returning to the venous system. They don't have any valves, and so blood can flow in any direction depending on whether you're lying down or standing on your head or standing up. They're lined with endothelium so that they're smooth, but they don't have any smooth muscle like the rest of your veins have. They are kind of big caverns into which blood is flowing back. All of your dural sinuses eventually are going to drain toward the base of the skull, and they're going to drain into the inferior jugular vein, which then is going to go back into your heart. In the next segment, we'll talk about the arachnoid.